In addition, Mr. Chair, to the manifestation of the Honorable Romulo, I respectfully move that we recommend Colonel Mendoza and Nelson Mariano for witness protection program, Mr. Chair, so they can help us solve and prosecute and conclude this issue surrounding us, because it now appears that the program against dangerous drugs was used not only to go against the real perpetrators, but even against competitors, as shown in the previous hearings, and even for purposes of political vendetta. And this time, I do not understand why even the official in the PCSO has to be placed in the narco list, only to be killed later on, and only to find out that there is no truth behind his inclusion in the narco list, Mr. Chair. We are confronted by a very comprehensive issue about the Philippine National Police, its power being used for the perpetration of various illegal activities, Mr. Chair. So I respectfully move, as I have moved already, Mr. Chair, that we place these two vital witnesses under the Witness Protection Program, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. So move. Thank you, Congresswoman Luistro. For the information of our honorable members, the DOJ is in close coordination with the Quadcom. And all these things that the honorable members are requesting are actually being noted down by the DOJ in order for them to take action immediately after the hearing today. So thank you, Congresswoman Luistro. The last to interpellate on the issue of EJK is Congressman Romy Acop. Congressman Acop, you are recognized.
Marami pong salamat, Mr. Chair. May I request that the former chairman of PCSO, General Pinili, sit beside General Acorda.
General Pinili?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Na-assign ka sa PCSO as part of the contingent ng CIDG noong 2020. Tama?
Sir, I was assigned in PCSO, sir, as detail, sir.
As?
Detail, sir.
Yes, I know.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Not as a CIDG, sir, but coming from PRO 7, sir.
PRO 7. So, yes, ang nag-request sa'yo na pumunta sa PCSO, ma-detail doon, ay si Colonel Garma. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Kasi magkasama kayo doon sa Region 7, eh.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Thank you. At ikaw yung opisyal na na-ambush na kasama mo yung asawa mo.
Yes, sir.
Kilala mo na kung sino umambush sa'yo o nagpa-ambush?
I have several suspects, sir.
At least, that's good enough kasi alam mo kung sinong iilagam mo. For this SITG, CIDG, ano po yung mga motives na nakita nyo in your investigation report?
In the report of the SITG, sir, the finding was to look into the previous assignment of General Barayuga.
Hindi, gusto ko lang yung tatlo na para mabilis tayo, iho. First is, sabi kanina ninyo kay Honorable Castro, involvement sa drugs.
Yes, sir. The recommendation was, there was two recommendations, the involvement in illegal drugs and the fact find, and the possible anomalies in PCSO which resulted in the filing of cases by the NBI against PCSO officials.
Now, may know yung basis ng anomalies sa PCSO, just like what anomalies?
Your Honor, sir, I am not privy to that, sir. I will check with the records, sir, sa CIDG, sir.
And according to your report, meron po kayong may final yung NBI na kaso against PCSO for corruption. Would that be correct?
The description by the is ITG is alleged anomalies in PCSO.
Okay. Now, have you ever conducted a background investigation on the late Attorney Wesley Barayuga?
Yes, sir. I think the investigators have conducted the background investigation on the person of General Barayuga, sir.
And may I know what was the finding of that background investigation?
In the discussion during case conferences, it was found out that General Barayuga has a modest lifestyle and actually doesn't have a vehicle used from home to his workplace, and accordingly, he has this Toyota Innova, but it's being used by his son. And his normally, daughter. He uses he commutes from his home to.
In other words, the late Wesley Barayuga is a simple man, or was a simple man. Hindi walang sasakyan, yung sasakyan niyang Innova, ginagamit pa ng kanyang anak.
Those were the findings of our investigators.
Even when he was assigned sa PCSO, simpleng-simple siya, wala siyang sasakyan, ang ginagamit niya, public transportation. Tama?
That was the findings, sir, of yes. The investigators.
Mr. Chair, ito pong issue na ito ay nagdala ng tension between the Lacans, yung graduate ng Philippine National Police Academy, at saka Cavaliers na graduate ng Philippine Military Academy, kasi yung pinatay ay graduate ng Philippine Military Academy class of 83 at yung alleged na nagplano ay members ng Lacan class 96 at ang ginamit ay class 2006 where Colonel Mendoza belong, right?
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you. At ito ay hindi po connected sa war on drugs. Ginamit ito na issue laban kay Attorney Wesley Barayuga for their selfish, yung kagaya ng sinasabi kanina ni Honorable Adjong, selfish or personal interest. Let me start. General Pinile, you were the one who recruited Attorney Barayuga. Tama po ba?
Yes, Your Honor, Mr. Chair.
Why? Because classmate mo siya.
He was my classmate and a lawyer.
Yes. And you know for a fact na may mga issues between Colonel Garma, the general manager, and your corporate board secretary. Tama po ba?
I have no personal knowledge, but I know that my classmate is very honorable man. He is not a fan of issuing.
I'm not asking whether the late Attorney Barayuga is an honorable man. Na-established na kanina. Simpleng-simple lang yung tao. Wala ngang sasakyan pag pumapasok. And that is true. Alam mo yun, di ba? Classmate mo eh.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. Do not describe him already. Na-establish na yun. Fact na yun. What we're trying to establish is the motive why he was killed or he was murdered. Di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. So you deny knowing the issues between your general manager, Colonel Garma, and your corporate board secretary? Hindi mo alam yun? Ikaw ang chairman?
Can I explain, Your Honor? Last March of 2020, I was in Davao and we are doing board meeting online. And my board secretary, since he's the one collating all reports, is always in the office. So from March to July 30, I was not in the office. So I don't really know the issues, but I know that my board secretary is not issuing board certificates if all the board members have not signed. So maybe that's the reason why he was targeted. Kasi I know that granting of authority to operate is solely given to the GM. So baka meron silang problema doon, and I don't have personal knowledge of their issues, Your Honor.
You do not have personal knowledge?
Yes, Your Honor.
Pero alam mo na may mga hindi napipirmahan ng board na nire-request ni GM Garma na mangyari?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. Kasi your general manager wanted to increase the number of franchises ng STL at gustong ipasok yung perya ng bayan.
I have an inkling on that, Your Honor.
Yes. You have an inkling? Mas yes, alam ko pa kasi yun na general manager ka.
On the issue of peryahan ng bayan. Because it's an illegal game.
Yes. And may I know if during that time, after the death of Attorney Wesley Barayuga, you texted his wife?
Maybe I inform her, Your Honor, because my classmate was killed, and as a classmate and also the chairman, it's my obligation to inform her, Your Honor.
That is your obligation, right?
Yes, Your Honor.
And you informed her na meron kayong parang separate investigation group to look into it. Tama rin po ba?
Because, you know, Your Honor, I inform our class president on how to solve this problem. So in order to relieve the pain of the wife of my classmate, I inform her that we have a parallel investigation so that it will be facilitated. And also, Your Honor, the class and other concerned groups posted a $1 million bounty for those who can help facilitate the investigation. So I would like only to tell this, Your Honor, that during the week, I was approached by the brother of my classmate, the sir. Sana, sir, hindi sana ito maging statistics lang. Kaya we assured him, kasi yung brother ni late Wesley is also a general in the fire service, I think.
Yes. Pero doon sa itinext mo kay Mrs. Pinili, and I have a copy of your text, you said something about the phrase privilege. I would like to read a part of it. Good morning, Mr. Sara. Hope you are doing fine and able to cope with the tragic loss of Wesley. My conversation with Yusek Q, siguro si Yusek Kinsa ito. Sino yung Yusek Q?
Yusek Kitain, Your Honor.
Kitain. And Senator Biji. Sino po yung Biji? Senator Bongo?
Bongo, Your Honor.
Were privileged communication or were considered highly confidential? What were those informations that you shared with Yusek Kitain and Senator Bongo na confidential? Hindi na confidential ngayon kasi masosold na yung kaso eh.
Regarding Your Honor, I said this because we have also already known the motive. So I reported this to them.
Let me stop you there, please. You have known the motive?
Yes, already, Your Honor.
Ano yung motive na alam nyo noon?
Now, the issues, now...
Ano yung motive na alam nyo noon? Pakisagot lang yung aking katanungan, kasi nanggaling po sa bungangan nyo po yun eh.
It was already been na...
Alam nyo na kung sino ang may kagagawan. Would that be correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. And for 4 years, you have suppressed it. You and some members of your class. Di ba? Or you want me to show proof of that? Alam ninyo, totoong nangyari, but you never did anything about it. Why? Because of fear. Am I correct?
Partly, Your Honor.
Partly. And which part is not true? Hindi ka makasagot. Anyway, bahala ka na sa iyong mga classmates.